Bless you, Mother.
Amen. Brother Herbert. Amen.
You've been on it to God for us this morning.
Yes, yes, amen.
Pastor Gail, and to the mother and the sisters and the brothers.
Yes,
right. Amen. Oh my gosh, I'm standing up here, but I'm shaking. I'm standing up here because I'm shaking. I've been reading this thing for the whole week. Trying to get the understanding to read here something that said different, or when over here said different.
Yeah.
And I was just disgusted because I said, I don't know what to say. How are you going to come out? How are you going to sound? Am I saying the wrong thing?
Right.
You know, what to do? How to say it?
Right.
Let them have it.
But the least you do for Jesus is push the inside.
Yes.
You know, and I'm going to say what I think it means to me.
Yes. No. Amen.
You know, because that's all I can do. I'm not a preacher yet. I would like to be. But I'm not a preacher, guys. I'm just taking it slowly and listening to what everybody has to say.
Amen. Amen.
You
Amen.
Know, and see where can what I can gather from there.
Amen.
Whatever.
Amen.
And you know, my part is.
My God, why has thou forsaken me?
And my Bible verse is Matthew 27. Verses 46 to 49.
Amen.
Amen.
And it says like this, and about the ninth hour, Jesus cried with a loud voice, saying, Eli, Elama, sabachthani. This is to say, my God, why hast thou forsaken me?
Amen.
Some of them that stood there, when they heard that, they said, this man called for Elias. And straightway one of them ran and took a sponge and filled it with vinegar and put it on a reed and gave to him.
Jesus.
The rest said, let be. Let us see whether Elijah will come down, will come to save him. You know, Jesus really didn't have a chance with those people. Mm-hmm. You know, because he was trying to tell them who he was, but they didn't want to believe him.
Amen.
You know, he cried and he cried. Imagine that torture.
Right.
Jesus. I can't even stand the sight of blood. When I was working, and they called for patients to do blood, I got to call one of my other co-workers to hold the hand or whatever.
Jesus.
Because I couldn't stand the needle going in and all them things. And they nailed him on the cross. That's something I couldn't take either. If I see that, like a Christmas show something coming, like an Easter show coming on, and they're nailing him, I flip the channel.
Right.
Or I will go out of the room and come back in
again.
Because just the blood and all, they're piercing him.
Yes.
You know, Jesus. And this lady is so helpless.
Yes.
And they nail the hand and they nail the teeth and they nail.
Jesus.
And when they stand him up, I say, oh no, it is finished then. Because what is going to stand do?
Right.
Because
Amen.
See, he there, he's so helpless, and just praying in his heart.
Jesus.
As somebody said, who can stand that?
Jesus.
I can't stand a pin, but a pin skip me.
Jesus. Right.
Nothing
Amen.
But to nail up there, and he did it all for us.
Yes.
And he said, we should say all to Jesus, I surrender.
Yes. Yes.
You know, because he did it for us.
Yes.
He didn't have to.
Yes.
Amen.
And when they pierced him and they took him in his side, water and all that blood, they said, truly this man is a man of God. Because they didn't know what to think afterward. But he stood up there and he took all the punishment.
Yes.
All Jesus forsaken.
Yes.
Just like we turn over there and we see Job. Job too was suffering. You know, but God called on Jesus to deliver him. And Job's wife told him, curse God and die.
Right.
But he didn't.
Yeah.
He called on Jesus.
Yeah.
You know, to help him.
Yeah.
And Jesus was the only one that can help.
Yes, Lord.
When he called God to him, he said, who am I?
Yeah.
You know, because he like everybody forsake him then.
Yes, Lord.
All his friends, even his wife, who he think would stood up with him. She said, curse God and die.
Jesus.
No, what is she thinking?
Right.
That she didn't want to see him in that state or whatever.
Right.
Yes. Because he was suffering so much.
Yes.
You know, he thinks that God has forsaken him.
Yeah.
You know, let's come and say, why has God forsaken him? Because that is the part of the scripture have to be fulfilled.
Mm. Yes. Yes.
And he had to go through this to show us.
Yes.
He came to earth to die for us.
Yes. Yes.
It is nothing on his own.
Yes.
It's because he came from heaven to earth.
Yes.
You know, to show us the way.
Yes. Yes.
And we have to now accept Jesus.
Yes.
He forsake him. But you know, all his friends forsake him. Was nobody on his side. And he cried with a loud voice.
Yes.
Why did God forsake him?
Yes.
Like he said, why? Like they abandoned him. Mm-hmm. Nobody to talk to. Nobody to say nothing in his favor. Because he didn't need any help at that time.
Yes.
Because he know what was in his mind.
Yes.
They didn't even know who there was nailing up there. They didn't know the thing they was doing to him, who he was.
Yes.
And he was the Christ.
Yes.
But the scripture had to be filled. When Jesus felt all the loneliness and all the pains, he cried out at the night of him.
Yes.
And he said, Jesus, Malo, why are you forsaken me?
Yes.
You know? And he just had to go through all this because he was sad and he was lonely.
Yes.
Yes.
And like he was neglected, nobody would come to his refuge or what? But
yes,
as I said, God don't need help with nothing.
Yes.
Amen.
He doesn't need help with nothing.
Amen.
He had to do it all alone.
Yes. Yes.
And he just had to show them he is God.
Yes.
And he's going to rise the third day.
Yes.
And he did.
Yes.
And he did. Yes. God is alive.
Yes.
Lonely.
Yes.
We feel like being neglected.
Yes.
Nobody want to body with us. Or you don't want to body with nobody. You just want to sit there and mope around.
Jesus.
Actually, sometimes I just sit there and mope around and find something to do. You know, that's how the loneliness feel.
Yes.
Then you have no one to talk to.
Yes.
Nobody want to listen. Nobody want to hear your problem.
Jesus.
But they came to Jesus.
Yes.
He is the only one that we want to hear. He's the only one that wants to know.
Yes.
He's the only one that can fix it.
Yes.
He said, bring it all to me.
Yes.
He's a burn bearer.
Yes.
And now he was there hanging on the cross.
Yes. Thank you, Jesus.
Everybody forsake him.
Yes.
Stand up there and he show that he's going to come down and he's going to live again.
Amen.
And he did.
Yes.
Because that's the kind of God he is.
Yeah. Right.
You know, we just have to thank him for everything that he's done for us. Still doing and about to do.
Yeah.
Yes. Because he is that God, he don't need no help.
Right.
And he went through all he had to because of us.
Yeah.
He did it all for us.
Yeah.
He came, he bled and he died for us.
Yes.
And we should take it into consideration.
Yes.
What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Because of God, we wouldn't be nowhere today.
Yes.
We wouldn't be nowhere.
Yeah.
Out there probably going from house to house.
Yes.
And don't even know what is Good Friday meant to some people.
Yeah.
And it's, you know, it's a day because they said Good Friday.
Yeah.
But if you ask them the meaning of it, I don't know it's Good Friday. And then some will tell you, every day should be Good Friday. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Every day should be Easter and be thankful. Yes.
Yes.
You know? But some just take it as this one day is Easter or it's Good Friday, and when the day pass is over,
you
go back to the old self. But we know as Christians what it meant to us.
Yes.
You know, we know what Good Friday means, and we know what Easter means. And we look forward to those 2 days.
Yeah.
Easter and Good Friday.
Yeah.
Because when Good Friday was getting ready to go on the cross for us.
Oh yes.
Yes.
He was getting ready to die for us.
Yes.
For all, because God loves us. And he do this all thing that we might be sinless, but we all are human. Everybody has sin still.
Yes.
You know,
yes.
if you say you have no sin, you're a liar.
Mm. Right.
You know, but everybody has sin.
Yes.
It is a small, nothing but small sin. Small sin, big sin, or whatever. It's sin.
Right.
All is sin.
Jesus.
All is sin. And God came and he did all that for us.
Yes.
No other but us. So we have to love him, give him praise and thanks because he's worthy today.
Yes.
And I'm so happy to know he's alive. He's risen.
Yes. Yes.
Because some churches only celebrate the death. Not the resurrection, that's the death. So everybody had no belief. They believe what they believe. And I believe what I believe. No arguments there. That's what you believe, and I know what I believe.
Right.
So today we give God praise and thanks because he is worthy.
Yes.
And right now, when he's not lonely anymore, he's not, or if he's lonely, after 6 o'clock he won't be lonely anymore.
Yes.
Because he rises again.
Amen.
He rose again.
Yes.
And
thank
he
you.
Going to the Father in heaven.
Hallelujah.
He will be happy.
Yes.
And
Jesus.
Not lonely anymore.
Thank you, Lord.
You know, when Beth Scott gave me this word, I was about to beat him up. You know? Beth Scott gave me this word or whatever, I like to beat him up. And Scott, what are you doing? I don't know what to say. He said, Mother, just go say what's in your heart.
Yeah.
Just get to it and say.
Amen.
He said, one day you're going to be a preacher. I would love that, but it takes time and study,
yeah,
you know,
right.
But I would like to be one day a preacher.
Amen.
You know, to stand up here and see how the people get excited and everything. I would like to do that.
Yes.
Lord. You know, to see how we really and truly feel when we get down in the gospel and to tell everybody what does send the Lord.
Right.
You know, it's not from your lips.
Yeah.
From your heart, you'll be saying these things too.
Yeah.
And believe me. Whatever we say and done, God is worthy to be praised.
Yes.
He is so worthy. And I give him thanks today and glory
yes.
what he is doing yes. to us right now.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.